You're welcome to Bingen. I am Yusuf Kenjo from Syria. I was director of Aleppo Museum until 2013. After 2013, I went to Japan. I work in Japan for 3 years. And now I am in Tübingen since 2 years. And I want to present you something about what the modern technology, what did for Syrian cultural heritage. Okay, and the question is, can the modern technology protect and document and rebuild of heritage during and after the conflict? It means, what is the role of the modern technology about what we said before, about the documentation, about rebuild, about the safe of heritage? Can there are something? Then I want to present you some example about this issue, and after that you can discuss again about this. But before I want to speak a little bit about Syria, about the archaeology of Syria. As we see here in this map, we see Syria has a long history, more than 1 year, 1 million years, and there are continuity since 1 million years until now. There are diversity in the cultural heritage. We have several culture, not just one culture. All the international culture exist in Syria. For this reason, the Syrian heritage is very important. But the most important thing is there are some steps of the human history just we can find in Syria, like the beginning of agriculture, which start 10,000 BC. We see also example. This is something interesting. I said we have a long history. This is the map show how many mission working every year in Syria before the conflict. Every year in Syria we have more than 140 mission from all the world working in Syria. The mission working in all period, in all region in Syria. We can see covered all Syria. This is reflect the importance of Syrian archaeology. As I said, the Neolithic revolution starts for first time is in Middle Euphrates in Syria, 10,000 BC Neolithic. We said agriculture, domestication of animal. And we have the oldest evidence about the first village, which is very well rebuilt, or very well organization for the most ancient village, which is Jerf al-Ahmar, 10,000 BC. They have the commune house. It's the first time where the people, the village, they concentrated in one house, or they work together for make the public houses or public building. Also, we discovered one of the most, the oldest painting in the world, which is painting in the wall. This is in Jadat al-Maghara, and this is old, more than 8,000 BC. Exists this. This painting is inside one house. This is public house, what we said, inside, around all the houses. Also, we have also the most old evidence about the urban life in Syria, around 4,300 BC. Emergency of urbanization, it means when the started big houses, big street, also, we have the beginning of the industry, like oil and wine. We start the first time in Syria. Okay, this is the introduction, and we see here now the situation after the current situation, after the actual conflict, after the civil war started since, I think, since, I don't know, 2011, they start the conflict. And we have this, you can see here the damage, the type of the damage in the archaeological site. All the damage you can imagine, you can find bombing, looting, illegal excavation, etc. That affected this, all this damage affected what we have as a result for this type of damage. We have completely building destroyed. We have partly damaged. We have stolen object and the sites destroyed. But the most important thing, what we have, the damage is more when big damage when the site is very important. When the site is very important, we have a big damage. I don't know why. Like in Palmyra, like Ebla and Mari. In the same time, we couldn't say how many percentage of the damage. We have 80%, 90%, or 70%. We have any percentage, but we have the most important site all damaged and big destroyed. This is the situation of Aleppo city. we see it how it is before 2010 and now. Big damage, destruction by multi-reason, multi-type, everything. The decomposition of damage. This is, I think, this is the first thing what I want to speak. And this is what the new technology, what document. This is very interesting because this is in 2012, it's in Palmyra. Palmyra is very important site because this Hellenistic Roman city. Then it's very rich city. Here we see that before 2011, here we see 2012, and we see the big damage. All this is a small point which is documented by satellite. It means there are illegal excavation. Illegal excavation, it means destroyed and looting. Here we can see two things. The first thing is after just 1 year, we show us how is the big damage. The second thing, we see the damage, but we couldn't stop. We couldn't stop. In that time, the situation is still okay. We haven't IS, we haven't any big conflict, but there are big damage. Then we see the damage, but we couldn't stop it. Also, again, Aleppo, this is the old city of Aleppo, which is two big old city, and the documentation by satellite came by one of international center, United Nations Institute for Training and Research, UNITAR, in 2014. They made a documentation for the older city. Also, we see here the city before and the city after 2014, a big damage, and it's documented by satellite. By satellite, they documented, they found 22 buildings destroyed, 48 civil damage, 33 modern damage, etc. This is 2014. It's very important, this documentation by satellite, because in that time, nobody can go to the older city, nobody knows what happened in the city. Then they give us in 2014, it's good information. But if they said, tell me now, 2018, no, because now everybody can go to the older city and knows what is the damage. One of this damage, we see this is one of the old school, very important religious and architecture, but it is destroyed by bombing, but nobody knows it is destroyed until we see by satellite, document by satellite, and they know something is destroyed, but the problem by satellite, they couldn't know which building exactly. In the documentation, what we see in 2014, there are some, they don't know exactly which building, and the building is really destroyed or not completely destroyed, but it gives us a good information. Anyhow, the result of that documentation by satellite, we see how it gives us an idea about how big the damage. When the color is dark, it means very hard damage. When is the color not so dark, is a little bit damage. It means give us a general idea. Another documentation by satellite, which came by ISOR, which is Cultural Heritage Initiative from USA. This is a project supported by USA government, and they working about the documentation. The damage usually in Syria during the conflict came by social media. We know the damage came by social media, and after that they take this news and they document the damage by satellite. Then the first instrument is social media. Social media was very, very important, very interesting, because it's, it is free, it is easy to get the news, but not as academical news or documentation. Again, another area of old city of Aleppo is 2000. This is in 2010, and okay, we can. This is the in 2015. We see big damage. Maybe not so very clear here, but it's big damage after a mega made a bombing, tunnel bomb, and big destroyed. If you comparison here, the situation 2014 was much better. There we see this building completely destroyed, and in this photo it is not so clear. Two of our museum is destroyed in this bombing, and this is one of our very beautiful, very important museum, is the popular tradition museum, which we see the situation is now like that after the bombing. Well, you can imagine how it is beautiful, how it is. The new thing is the temple of Tel Indara. This is a temple very important. Is they have at least two culture, Aramean and Hittite culture, and is the one of the few temples exist in the city, and. We can see the temple is like that. The Leon stone is very famous, but it is destroyed. The last, I think, this is the just 1 month ago, destroyed by a Turkish airstrike in January. And we see how it is around 30 or 40% of the temple destroyed. We see it in the map, not so very clear, which S4 also documented the damage by satellite. We see here before and after the damage, but not so very clear, I'm sure. But as we said, the idea for S4, for example, after we heard the news about destruction, and we came with made documentation for the damage. Here we see the site 2014. There are no any damage in 2014, but now after we see the damage, we look to the site again by satellite, and we see the site not only the damage by Turkish military attack, but there are several buildings, big part for construction, etc. It means we must look to the site every time, not just when heard about the news. Rebuilding of Syrian heritage, I will talk just about the just example. We take Palmyra. The same thing, the documentation by satellite, we have several examples, but all like that, as I present example. About Palmyra, we have two examples. Baal Temple and Palmyra Arch. Of course, Palmyra is very famous because because they have a lot of archaeological remain. Also, it's Hellenistic Roman Byzantine period, and it's very important culture because it is between the west and east. This is mosaic culture exists in Palmyra, and there are a big damage from the beginning of the conflict, but. When came IS-Daesh to Palmyra, start to destroy, but not destroyed everything. They was seems to be very bad. Of course they are very bad, but they choose what is important in Palmyra, and they destroyed Palmyra. Not destroyed everything, but they destroyed what is the most important. Like for example, the tower tomb. We see here also documentation by satellite by ASUR. And one of the most important thing and beautiful thing is in Palmyra is the tower tomb. After the tower tomb, they destroyed also the Baal temple, Baal Shamin, which is a very famous story. But the most important temple, Baal temple, is the most important in Palmyra, and they start. And also you see the documentation, what is before, after, and how which part of this destroyed. We see the photo for the after the destruction, which is a start company Econom, the documentation of Palmyra. They started the documentation and with the idea if they can reconstruct with from the destruction, they can reconstruct the site like that they imagine the reconstruction that for that from the after the explosion, document the site and reconstruct. But we have that documentation before the destruction for this. if I can open the documentation of maybe. Okay. I want to open the video. This one later.
This one.
Anyhow, the temple was documented by Japanese mission in Palmyra, and I've completely documentation and very good documentation. Okay, this is the documentation before the destruction, before the war, and I think it's very, very good documentation. But the question, from the question we can discuss maybe later, from this documentation we can rebuild again. It is possible to.
Yeah.
Okay, the second thing I want to speak about the Arch, of course, Palmyra Arch, also destroyed by Daesh. And, you know, maybe a very famous replica of the Arch, which is made by expert Institute of Digital Archaeology. And they made by high technology from the photography, and they made using high technology to make a replica for the Arch of Palmyra. And well, you see it was in London and in Italy and Emirates Arabs. Okay, but as in the newspaper came, should we celebrate a replica of the destroyed Palmyra Arch? We must reconstruct what is destroyed or not. Oh, we can rebuild ancient site or have the ruin to remind us of our cruel history. Then it is okay if we can make a replica for what is destroyed, rebuild what is destroyed, or leave. This is the hard question what we have. We have, as we see in Aleppo, we have many buildings destroyed, and in Palmyra also. And the question is, can rebuild again? Can rebuild from the documentation we have? Okay, we have a good several sites, several buildings. We have a good documentation, but it is okay to rebuild this site. It's valid to think to rebuild like that, to rebuild the site, and in particular the Arch of Palmyra, because they have a big propaganda about the Arch of Palmyra. They put it in many places, many sites. What mean that? Of course, it's very important to speak about the cultural heritage, to show the people the importance of Syrian cultural heritage. But what is the most important? The people of Palmyra or the Arch of Palmyra, and as they plan to send this Arch to Palmyra also, which is not yet, it's impossible to send now. Then we can we came again about the same question. Document, we have a document, documentation, protection, and rebuild with modern technology. We know the modern technology can make a good documentation before and after the war, but can be rebuilt again, or just as documentation. And as also we have destroyed monument, how will they report part destruction? Need a lot of financial support, need expertise. Who will do that, all this thing? And the cooperation with local community or not? They exist cooperation with local people or not? It's just between UNESCO, international organization, with local organization, not with the people. Oh, yes, must the people, they will participate. They must first the people, Syrian people go back to Syria and after that rebuild, or first we rebuild. All this question I think need to discuss, but we must stop here. And thank you very much for your attention.